Well, a very warm welcome, everyone, to Thursday evenings and to this concert, our fifth concert in this series of virtual performances at Ardingly College. As usual, you'll see I've got Gerald here with me, and he's been interested, like we all have, of course, in how the pupils are getting on with their music. He's just been sat in the book room like he normally does, just wallowing away the time. So he's enjoying lockdown, perhaps more than most of us, but there we are. Tonight's concert is another dual house affair. We've got the girls from Toynbee, a boarding house, and Burgess, a day house, coming together, joining forces for this musical entertainment and, as you'll see a bit later, a bit of artistic entertainment as well. It's our great pleasure as well to share this concert with the local community, and in particular the local care homes, which some of our pupils volunteer at during the school term. And I'm really, really hopeful that the power of music and the joy of music will provide solace and enjoyment at this time for those who are finding things much harder, I think, in those environments. We do have some words as well, which I'm going to play for you now from Phoebe, who has been a regular visitor.
Hi, everyone at Woodlands and Maplehurst. My name's Phoebe, and some of you at Woodlands may know me. I hope you're all keeping high spirits in this strange time. At Ardingly, we thought it'd be a really nice idea if we could share some of the more creative things we've been up to over the last couple of months. Some of the girls at Toynbee and Burgess have prepared some music and art for you all to listen to and look at. We tried our best to use a lot of the songs that you've liked listening to when we visit. We hope you enjoy it, and we'll see you as soon as we can. Thank you.
So, as Phoebe mentions, we have some music and some art for our audience tonight. However, before we start this evening, I've had an opportunity to catch up with the Toynbee head of house, who is Ruby, and she's in London, I think, at the moment, and we're just seeing how she's getting on. So, firstly, Ruby, I suppose, how's the lockdown been for you?
I'm doing very well, thank you, sir. It's been definitely an adjustment to normal life, but I'm not doing too badly. I've been able to get out every day, and with the weather being so nice, it has been really nice.
We've been really lucky, haven't we, with the weather. Usually sort of April, May can be dreadful in England, and we've been really lucky. Have you been out anywhere else? What have you doing anything else?
I have been doing quite a few bits when I have some free time. So I've been cooking quite often with my mum, doing some baking, which has been fun. And I always go out with my dog in the evenings. So yeah.
What's your dog called?
I have Millie. She's a Jack Russell, and she's quite hyper, so we have to go out quite often.
So lots of walking. What about your cooking? What have you been baking?
So I've made quite a lot of things. Mum's a big fan of banana bread, so the banana bread always comes out. What else have we had? We've had some quiches, some tarts, just a little mix of things, really.
Sounds really good. Yeah, Mrs. Stafford makes a mean banana bread, so if you're taught by her, ask her about that next year. Yeah, that's one of her top-notch cakes. Anyway, let's move on. What about this lockdown? Sorry, Gerald's trying to escape. There he is. What about this lockdown? Have you been doing anything that you kind of wouldn't normally be doing?
I've had a lot more time to do reading. I mean, I've started my personal statement, so I thought I'd throw in a few books into it. Some David and Goliath, some Malcolm Gladwell. So that's been interesting. But yeah, I just have, I think, a lot more free time to do things besides just school.
Yeah, absolutely. We can focus on a few things that we haven't necessarily done. What about what you've missed at this time? Because it is an alien situation, isn't it, we find ourselves in?
Definitely. Well, living in London, I did used to go out on the weekends quite often to Central. So that has been very different. And also my friends, because I'm obviously in the boarding house, so a lot of my friends are international. And thankfully, some people have been allowed to go out and see, you know, one friend at a time. But because a lot of my friends, you know, are in Hong Kong or in Ukraine, it's not exactly as easy.
So what have you guys been doing to sort of stay in touch? Have you had house activities?
Yeah, well, on the weekends I have little virtual parties with my friends, which has been quite fun. But in school, we've had a really range of things to do. So we've done Saturday activities. So I led a workout one, the fifth led a yoga workout, and the shell did cooking. So teaching people to cook like their favourite cookies. So yeah, and we're planning on doing a sort of house dinner in the last weekend of next half term, so that would be good. So loads of little activities there, maybe some live performances and yeah, some speeches. That should be good.
That'll be a lovely way to finish. When I spoke to Archie last week, they Cross House had had that as well. I think it was very successful.
Yeah, I have to say, so we were inspired by them, but
there we are, absolutely. And just finally, before we move on to a little bit about the sort of concert, have you got any advice for the girls sort of in your house and of course in Burgess who are probably watching this about this time and how to sort of help sort of guide our way through these uncharted waters, I suppose?
I think one thing that I would say is to try and keep in contact with people as much as we can, because a lot of people at this time can kind of isolate themselves, obviously in isolation. So I think it is important to keep in touch with everyone and make sure that everyone's doing okay, because you know, a lot of people are so used to spending, you know, that time with people day in and day out, and it's going to be a big loss not having that. So to make sure that you are there for each other, I think is one of the most important things we can do right now.
Absolutely, yeah, I completely agree with you. Let's move to the concert then, and what we've got tonight. This is special, I think, because this is a link which is provided really by the memory, the music and the memory project. You know, the inspiration really for tonight is that project, and obviously the involvement of the girls. So can you tell us what you've all been doing throughout the course of the year and what this project is about?
Yeah, of course. So Miss Porter has been trying to keep our callovers quite interesting. So we watched this video and it was about how music can have such a significant impact on people's memories and also their emotions. And she thought that, you know, if we were able to help people and make it easier for some people to deal with how they're feeling right now, then that would be an amazing thing for us to do. So we have quite a varying range of talents in our house, with creative being one of them. So a lot of musical and artistic, which I think is new. I don't know if people have done that before, but we've incorporated some artwork, some GCSE artworks, because they didn't get to show off this year, so that's nice that they get to do that. She also wanted to make it like a collaborative, so that we get to both have the experience with Burgess as well as just with Toynbee, so we get to see or showcase the talent of so many girls in Ardingly. So that's been great. And also because in Thursday EP, a lot of our Toynbee girls do, as you said earlier, go to the care homes. We thought that that would be something that was really nice for them. And because we spent so much time with them over the past few months, that this may be an experience for them to feel like we are spending time with them virtually.
Absolutely. And we know about the power of music with that. And I'm sure it'll be absolutely gratefully received, all of this effort that you've put in what hopefully in a small way will make a difference to their experience at this time. So moving on to tonight then, we've got a very varied concert this evening, but we've also managed to find some archive footage from the house song earlier this year. How was that for you girls in Toynbee?
It was really fun. So we chose to do You Can't Stop the Beat in Hairspray. And it was a collective vote, and we decided over a varying song choice, because it was the 2000s, that was the theme. So we had a little look at all the songs in there, and that was great because the lower six take responsibility for the whole thing, really. And that was really fun because it was the first year that we got to properly really be involved in it. So Louise and I took the complete lead of the musical element of it, and me and Jasmine Pentley-Chuck did the choreography. And we had an absolute great time. Every night from 9 to 9:30, the boarders would go out, practice. We put in a lot of effort, and we didn't win, but it was the taking part that counts, and we had a really good time doing it. And the younger girls really put in so much effort, especially those who hadn't done it beforehand, because they didn't know what to expect, and they really pulled through. So we are very proud of them, and it didn't go unnoticed, all their efforts. So yeah, it was really good.
And it is obviously for you guys in lower six, next year will be a bit different because you'll go into one house, so it becomes your last kind of collective Toynbee experience in that competition, of course.
Definitely.
I think that's all the questions I've got at the moment for you. Is there anything that you'd like to add or anything to add just before we start the concert?
I would just like to say thank you for everyone who was even like remotely involved in this, for all the girls in Burgess, all the girls in Toynbee, you, sir, Miss Porter, everyone. Thank you for making all the effort, because it is really important for people to be able to have this musical element in their lives, even virtually. And I hope everyone's looking forward to watching it, because I certainly am. And I hope everyone feels positive and cheerful about the way in which music can impact us. So, yeah, I'm really looking forward to it.
Great, thank you. From a really buoyant Ruby there in London, who is, as you see from her smiley face, always joyful despite the situation. So my thanks to her, of course, as well, for joining me just to have a chat about how she's getting on. And as she says, enjoy tonight's concert. It's always the same. We provide the notes. Make sure you've got the nibbles, something to eat, something to drink. As we watch this very varied concert from the girls, where we've got a bit of house song in there as well, but also all kinds of performances. And of course, as was mentioned, some artwork as well. And a little plug for art as well. Just while I'm here, Miss Grover, our wonderful head of art, she has posted recently on Twitter. We've got two things, obviously the GCSE and A-level, I think, exhibition work, which is all going up online. So do have a look at that amazing work, but also the virtual art in the lockdown. And I think that's something that's such a powerful tool, which we can reflect on when we return. So, if you're an artist, go for it. Absolutely. But at this point, Gerald's just jumped off my lap, so I think that's enough for him. So it's time to start the concert. So enjoy, and we'll see you on the other side.
Oh. been crazy, couldn't you tell? Threw stones at the stars and the whole sky fell. I'm covered up in strawberry up on table. I drank and I sang and passed in the stable. I dragged you straight in the muddy ground. And you sent me back to where I roam. Well, I cursed and I cried, but now I'm for my heart like something. Well, it came or it be and it boiled for them. Oh, it's ringing. Ring like crazy, ring like hell. Turn me back into that wild hair. Ring like silver, ring like
Johnny Porter, and I'm 8 years old, and I will be singing You Are My Sunshine. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are grey. You never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. The other night, dear, as I lay sleeping.
'Cause you
Well, what a fantastic evening of musical entertainment we've just seen there from the girls in Toynbee and Burgess House. And you probably noticed as well, there was a cheeky entry there from a very young member of Toynbee House, Miss Porter's daughter, Bonnie, starting out her musical journey as well with a lovely performance. As you'll see, Gerald has been here with me all the time, listening intently to everyone's performance. So all it really saves for me to say again is a measured thanks to all of those girls who have performed in the concert this evening. It does take huge dedication and self-discipline to do that, to provide that joy for all of us. And again, a special thanks to those girls who are supporting the local volunteering with Mr. Woodall in the local care homes. I know that their efforts and their creativity has provided great joy for those local care home residents, especially during this troublesome time. So as usual, we will be here again next week at 6 p.m. on Thursday evening. I think it's probably about time we stop. As you can see, Gerald's getting a little bit restless here. But again, my thanks to Ben Freer for all his work. My thanks to Louise Porter and Alex Hill for their support as well in helping with this project, alongside, of course, Simon Woodall. So all it remains for me to say, as you probably know, those seasoned campaigners that have been involved with these concerts, it is difficult times. Keep yourselves occupied. The music Twitter feed is always a place for some kind of information or musical inspiration. But as Boris is still not saying, but I am saying, stay safe, be safe, keep safe. Bye for now.